Hi, in this demo, we want to show all of the pictures related to our case in a document and list them. So what we actually want is to repeat this table or this row for every picture and then just show all the pictures. You can see that in my case at this moment, there are three pictures of motors related. So I want to show all of the pictures of these motors related to my case. This is a little bit more tedious, I give you that, but we'll just go through it step by step, and I will make sure that all of the queries that are written or are shown are actually also on our YouTube channel, so you can just copy paste from there. Okay, cool. What's up next? Let's first create a data source to select all of our pictures. New data source, let's call it the Sokol data source. We're going to call this demo case, and it's all files that we want to select. It's of course a list of files. Let's just save it, and in this case let's use the Sokol builder. Am I doing this correctly? Yeah, I'm doing this correctly. So what we actually want now is to go and find the show the API names. I want to filter the content document link. So we want actually, so this is really deep down in the belly of Salesforce files. So we want to follow the document content link. So this is just linking our documents to our case. So our file actually to our case. Okay, this is the object I'm going to select. Then from this one, I need the, actually I don't need that much. The only thing I need is, the linked entity, of course, and from the content document, I want to follow the relation. I want to find the latest published version, and I want to get this ID from that one. Okay, so we're there. I'm going to add a filter because I want to select only the case only the files linked to the case that I'm currently working on. So that's with linked entity ID. Going to review. Everything looks perfect. Okay, sorry, I forgot to add a filter. That's why the review is so important. Okay, so everything looks perfect. Now I can just save this query. This query will not select any pictures. It will only select the files related to my case. So in this case, the files are three pictures. Okay, cool. What's next? We're going to create a child data source on this one, and this is where it gets really interesting. We're not going to select any pictures from this one. We are going to select pictures from this one, of course, and we're going to call it demo case, case pictures. So we're going to select from files, of course, so that's important. The image name in this particular case is not important, not applicable, so we're just going to remove that one here. The parent's query field is going to be the, I'm just going to copy paste it from my screen here. So I will make sure it's all inside the, so that's the latest published version. So you can see that here, latest published version ID. So that's the latest ID. A file can have multiple versions. So this is the latest version that I want to use. And then I'm just going to also copy paste a full query. So, and I'm just gonna put that one here. This is a complex one. I'll make sure it's linked to our YouTube video. So what this query actually says is that it will select from this content document all of the stuff that I actually need. So the version data, the title of the document, and it has to be linked to my to my record ID, of course. Eh? So looking good. Okay. I'm just going to remove this one here and remove this one, this dot here as well. So it's the latest published version ID equals the latest published version ID of the parent, record ID. Okay, If you read up on related data sources, you will understand all of this. So what it just does, it says, I want to select all of the versions, all of the content, all of the files that are related to my parent. So this is a variable, and this variable is actually also linked to our parent. Okay, so I think this is actually it to select our data. So that already looks very good. It's very complex, I understand, but just read through it a couple of times and you will understand. Okay, next up, we're going to create our document. So we have a document that looks like this one here. So we want to repeat this table or row for every picture, and then we want to have this picture here where it sits with the placeholder. So let's go for this one. First of all, of course, let's add our data sources. It was all files. Okay, this one is looking good. Select the children. This one is also looking good. Great. Add config type. And the config type is table pics row. So we're going to make it of type table row. Data source is all our files. Its merge field is table pics, of course. Okay. Then this row, we actually want to make a child of the type picture. Okay, it's gonna be called issue pick. Okay, yeah, I always take the name of my content type the same as the name of my merge field. Okay, the formatting, so we don't want to have any weird looking overview in our document, so the width has to be fixed. So it will mean that this width here is fixed, and just the height will vary dependent on the height of the actual picture. So, okay, let's do this. I'm going to save it. It's already saved. Looking good. Let's give it a try. Click the button. It will select all of the information, send it off to PDF Butler. And what we see here is perfectly an overview of all our pictures that are actually inside our list. So it seems to have worked. Only these merge fields are still there. Let's fix that. I'm a perfectionist, so I want to get rid of them. That's a very easy fix. Let's remove the containing paragraph or the merge field only. Okay, so let's save this one and generate again. So we'll again take all of the pictures, send it off to PDF Butler, and have it merged inside the document. You see, no more merge fields, cool overview of our pictures. So everything is looking good, everything looking as expected. And yeah, well, that's how you create a list of pictures. Thank you for watching.